I will come back and Naren. And if you are interested to know more about hash, Hashcash, proof of work, email spam, Bitcoin, so we will try to touch upon some of these definitions in this video. If you want to increase your understanding of the Bitcoin, blockchain and related concepts, you need to have a basic understanding of the hash functions as we know in the computer science and its use cases. So this video tries to cover some of the basics of that need. Let's say you have some of the physical files on some people like Arya, Adam, Boss and Zendaya, and you have some ledgers 01 to 26 and you want to keep these files in a ledger. Let's say you want to keep Arya and Adam in ledger 01 and Boss in 02 and Zendaya in 26. So how you are trying to arrange these ledgers is by picking the first alphabet and mapping A to 01, B to 02, similarly Z to 26. So this is a simple schema hashing that you're trying to map the files to the ledgers, and this is a simple example of hash function. So here this mapping is the hash function. So hash function actually is a function which maps data of arbitrary size to fixed size, and the output is known as hash value or the digest. So what is the cryptographic hash? It is a hash function with a few more secure features. The output is fixed size, as discussed, it's a bit array of fixed size, and the hash function should be a one-way function. So that is, when you create a hash from the input message, it should be practically infeasible to reverse the operation. That is, given the hash, it should be infeasible to get the original message. And the function should be deterministic. That means, if you take the same input message and hash it as a multiple operation, not that you hash twice or thrice, but same input message, hash it once and see the output hash. If you do this operation whenever, like with the same input message, the hash value should not differ. It should return the same hash always. So that is the deterministic requirement of the cryptographic hash function. And it should be infeasible to find two messages with the same hash value. And if there's a small change in the input message, there should be a very large change in the hash value generated. That means the output hash generated after a small change in the input message should be uncorrelated to the previous hash value. And there are some secure hash algorithms to use for hashing, like SHA 1, 2 and 3 and some more. SHA 256 is a hash function as part of the SHA 2 family, which outputs a hash value with 256 bits. There is one more called Scrypt, and it is used in cryptocurrencies for the proof of work scheme, and we will check the proof of work in later slides. And some of the use cases of the hash function includes indexing data. Normally you will try to create some hash tables while processing the data of your applications in various algorithms. And fingerprinting to detect any duplicate data that you are processing in case of checksum, where you want to detect any data corruption. And in digital signatures, where you use it for the authenticity of the digital message using private and public keys. In case of MAC, message authentication codes, for authentication, data integrity, and here there will be a shared secret key used instead of public and private keys like digital signature. And another important function of hash functions is the proof of work, and it is used in cryptocurrencies. And Hashcash is a POW system normally used for spam protection in emails. So what is proof of work? There are some use cases of the proof of work, like in the email spam, to detect whether an email is a spam or not. So you want to know how you can discourage spammers in sending the unwanted mails. And in case of denial of service attacks, DOS attacks, let's say you want to avoid DOS attacks on any service. And also in case of Bitcoin mining algorithms, you want to make the mining process very hard so that you can discourage the unwanted manipulation of the data in the Bitcoin network. So these are some of the use cases of the proof of work. So as I said, Hashcash is a POW system. So that is used in email spam. So how we do that is, when as an email server, like you will ask the sender for a particular header format for the email, and the format will contain a hash with a peculiar characteristics, that is the expectation from the sender at the receiving end. So that hash will include date and the recipient address to make it unique for each message, and also it will expect some constant number of starting zeros in the hash. So this indirectly makes it hard to compute this hash. And we are trying to make this computation of the hash a bit hard to discourage the spammers to send lots of mails. Because when they are dealing with sending lots of mails, they have to spend a lot of computing power to generate these hashes to send as headers. So that doesn't help them in the overall picture. The cost will have a negative impact on their overall aim of sending these spam mails. Whereas at the recipient, the verification of the structure of this data is very cheap. So whenever a mail comes, the recipient can easily detect whether the header is of the known format, so that you can easily identify whether it is a spam or not. So POW in Bitcoin. So as part of the Bitcoin network, there will be a lot of transactions going on, and these transactions are combined into blocks, and a list of such blocks is called the blockchain in the Bitcoin network or in any cryptocurrency. So each block in this blockchain will have a cryptographic hash of the previous block of the blockchain. So this is where the use case of the cryptographic hash function comes into picture through this proof of work in Bitcoin networks. So when there are multiple transactions in a Bitcoin network, someone needs to validate these transactions so that they can put them in a block, the blockchain. And this is effectively the mining in Bitcoin network. And whenever somebody does that work, which is called as mining, then they can get some rewards for this operation. And as part of this mining, the person who is doing the mining will collect the unconfirmed transactions from the users on the Bitcoin network. And their goal is to form a block with these transactions. Once the block is formed, the network, the Bitcoin network, will accept that block only with certain criteria. So this is where the POW will be introduced with some expectation of how that block value should be. So they will set, the network will set some difficulty target that should be achieved for the block to pass. So that to reach that target, the hashing will come into picture and it will need some amount of computing power to get that result. So with that requirement, you will establish the trustworthiness. So the target difficulty in these cases are controlled differently. Like in case of Hashcash for the email spam, some leading zeros in the hash value can exponentially increase the hardness of the computing problem. So it will become even harder by adding just one zero to the setting of the expected. So in case of Bitcoin mining, the generated hash value as part of the block is considered as an integer, and there is an expectation that this integer should be less than a target integer, and the Bitcoin network will decide this target integer, that will indirectly decide the target difficulty. So as a recap, what we touched till now in this video. So we checked what is the cryptographic hash function is and some examples of it, like SHA series, SHA 256, Scrypt, and the use cases of the hash functions like the indexing, fingerprint, checksum, digital signatures, MAC, and the proof of work. Whereas the proof of work has different use cases like email spam through Hashcash or the DOS, preventing the DOS attacks, and even in Bitcoin mining where it tries to group the transactions into a block so that they can be put into the blockchain. If you find this useful, please like, subscribe and share, and thank you for watching.